we get to draw first. With this hand is sweet. So yeah, as long as it doesn't have the Horde Smelter, this game I think we're looking good. Obviously, I mean, we have a lot of colors, we have Heavy Arbalest, a bunch of great defensive creatures. Now the question becomes, which order do we play things? I think we play Gust Skimmer here. Not Plague Mirror? Yeah. Maybe we do play Plague Mirror. If he has Blissedict Shaman, that way he shamans. Yeah, we want to save the Gust Skimmer. The Gust Skimmer can trade with his Glinthawk Idols, which is obviously very valuable, so we don't want to throw it away here to a Blissedict Shaman. I imagine we're going to get him actually this game with this Quicksilver Geyser. That's what I predict will happen. So we can either play Narcrophilco or we can play both of our two drops. It's close. I'm going to go ahead and play both two drops. Get the shields up. We'd love to draw a Pyroclasm, or a Arc Trail, obviously. This is fine. We'll take six. And now the question becomes, what's the play? I think the play is just Arbalest and a Replica. The Replica can just trade with his Duelist. And now with Heavy Arbalest, we're threatening to equip and just start blowing his team away. We didn't want to see that. Alright. Probably going to chump the Duelist now, actually, with our Gust Skimmer. Yeah, I don't really want to take 8 there. So, we could double block, actually. And trade both of these for the Duelist. But I don't think we need to do that when we have the Arbalest coming online. Ah, this is close. I'm still sort of enamored with this idea of getting it with Quicksilver Geyser, but maybe it's not going to happen. So if we double lock, oh no, don't kill anything, he's first strikes down the, I'm just being stupid, it doesn't actually achieve anything, he just first strikes down the skimmer, and then, okay, same thing. Alright, so we just jump. Don't want to take 8. No shatter, please no shatter. Your last card shatter? Ugh, that's filthy. Oh, okay. That's fine. That, ooh, hello, big guy. Things just got interesting. Huh, we need some choices now. So we can just equip our replica and say go. All of our dudes up. That's probably the best play. That has to be better than just playing the Marauder, right? If we just play Marauder and say go, if he has like an arrest or something, we're potentially in trouble. Yeah, this is safer. So we'll make the safe play. Block and shoot a gold mirror, or I can just block and, yeah, I can block and shoot. I think I like shooting and bouncing the glider though, actually. Because by bouncing the glider, unless his last card is a land, he can't re-equip the husk onto it, so when he replays it, we can then shoot it next turn. Although this means we're not going to have something. That's fine though, we can always just play and bounce with this in the one turn with our Rogue Replica. So yeah, so now he has to have a land in his hand. Oh, is that interesting? Okay. So now we need to draw. We'd like to draw land. Don't need to, but it'd be nice. Huh. So what's our play? I think we just play Nurgle up and say go. Right, and that way we, because we don't want to put the Arbalest onto the Clagmere since we want to use it for mana to cast these Fangor Marauders in our hand. Interesting turn of events with this Blizzardstrike Shaman. So just no Hordesmelter, please. I wonder if just playing the Marauder was better than. Eh, probably not. I think that turn was pretty good. It's gonna be hard for him to erase these, trying to just do damage. Sure. Ooh. Okay. So I'm at 8 effectively, I'm at 5 effectively, that's fine. But we really like to draw a land. Did. It's possible you're considered leaving up just the Quicksilver Geyser here, but I don't think you could possibly be right. This just feels like it has to be better. Block. No whammies this turn. Yep, that's fine. No Galvanic Blast now either. So we can untap. And off to the races we go. Okay, so now, man, if we draw another red mana too, we're in really good shape. What's the play? I assume we just equip replica, shoot a gold mirror, gain 5, bounce a glider, gain 5. I mean, gaining 10 here seems pretty good. Are we afraid of him having a sack and attacker? Not really. Do we shoot now? No, we don't need to shoot now. Alright, come on. No Hordesmelter Dragon. Actually, even Hordesmelter Dragon's fine at this point. Let's see. Did he just that guy? Okay. I guess there's no reason to actually bounce right now, right? We can just take the 4, go to 5. Although, do we want to use our mana efficiently and bounce right now? I don't think so, actually. I think we just want to take it. Gotta keep our replicant in play. See what he does after combat. This also, we can move Arbalest over to Plague Mirror next turn if we draw a land, and just start shipping down this glider, and leave our replica in play. That's not what I actually wanted to draw. Now I kind of wish I'd bounced just so that I could play the second Marauder. I should have thought that through more. Yeah, I definitely should have. Why didn't I bounce? That was just terrible. I think I actually might just equip the finger motor now then instead of trying to race. It's kind of weird to put Arbalest on Marauder, but I just want to get his team dead, I think. Make up for my mistake last turn this way. Okay, this is definitely better, because now this way I get to have my Arbalest active when he replays his glider, so he can't actually just run it back out here, which is pretty sweet for us. Who's he gonna try to equip? Okay, another 5 life, thank you. And ooh, a silver mirror. Okay, well, I'm just gonna replay this other Fangren Marauder. Fangren and friends. That's fine. We'd really enjoy drawing ourselves a mountain. Oh, and we did. Okay. So this one's looking pretty good. And now we're just going to go ahead and move Arbalest onto our Plague Mirror. Play ourselves a silver mirror. And we can attack. Do we? I actually don't like attacking here because he just triple blocks and we trade off from Marauder for no reason. And this way, even if he has Horde Smelter Dragon, we're just. I think we're just finishing him. And he has no good blocks. Now we have everything up. And now the only thing he can have is Wrath, which might reach Regenerate or Tangle Hulk, bounce his token, and kill him. And so this should be game.